Anyway, let's get on to the next video. So I thought this one was quite interesting because I've seen the film. You might have seen it before. It's quite an old film. But I remember watching it before I transitioned and I was kind of interested in it. So this one, yes, a doctor discovers a potion that transforms him from a man and of his man to a woman. Okay, so this is... this is a, I think it's Hammer Horror, English horror thing. Quite, they did a lot of stuff back in like 60s, 70s. If you live here in the UK, when I was growing up and stuff, they would have like stuff on late night on TV and stuff like that of the Hammer Horror. You know, I had like Dracula and things that I used to do. But this one... completely different story. It was taken from like the Dr. Jekyll, Mr. Hyde story, and they had I think it's called Dr. Jekyll and Miss Hyde. I think it's called that. I might be wrong. I will find out. But yeah, I remember seeing this on TV before I transitioned. But in this, is he drinks a potion and he becomes a woman. So I think I remember watching it, thinking, "Wow, I wish I could have something like that." So that did cross my mind, but let's have a watch a bit and just see what's what. Okay. Anyway, let's listen to a bit of this. Anyone?
Welcome back to Movie Recap. Today I will tell you about a sci-fi movie called Dr. Jekyll and Sister Hyde.
A bit louder. Dr. Jekyll and Sister Hyde. That's what it's called. Dr. Jekyll and Sister Hyde. I don't think it's a sci-fi. It's a horror, without a doubt. Horror film. Sci-fi.
Jekyll dedicates his life to the curing of all known illnesses. However, his lecherous friend Professor Robertson remarks that Jekyll's experiments take so long to actually be discovered, he will no doubt be dead by the time he is able to achieve anything. Haunted by this remark, Jekyll abandons his studies and obsessively begins searching for an elixir of life, using female hormones taken from fresh cadavers supplied by murderers Burke and Hare. Reasoning.
So, yeah, I mean, it was a while ago since I last watched this film, but it's trying to find cures for all known illnesses, which is a very good thing, but decides to abandon that because obviously he'll die before he can do that. And he decides to get dead female women bodies because females, well, I don't know if he's already said this because I've watched this bit before, because they live longer.
And he is anyway. Able to achieve anything. Haunted by this remark, Jekyll abandons his studies and obsessively begins searching for an elixir of life, using female hormones taken from fresh cadavers supplied by murderers Burke and Hare, reasoning that these hormones will help him to extend his life, since women traditionally live longer than men and have stronger systems.
So yeah, Burke and Hare. So Burke and Hare were the, I think they were in Scotland, weren't they? And the real life gravediggers. So this is the thing with Hammer Horror. They take things and they change them around, but kind of in an interesting way. I mean, if you know who they're covering, it's more fun. Indeed. Yeah, so, you know, because women live longer than men. Fair enough, yeah. I don't know if that works, taking hormones, but yeah. So he decided that we're going to use women's ovaries to make his elixir, so he can live a lot. People can live longer. But yeah, just take estrogen, you can live longer. Wow.
Apartment above Jekyll, a family is living: an elderly mother, her daughter Susan Spencer, and Susan's brother Howard. Susan is attracted to Jekyll, and he returns her affections, but is too obsessed with his work to make advances. Mixing the female hormones into a serum and drinking it not only has the effect of changing Jekyll's character for the worse, but also of changing his gender, transforming him into a beautiful but evil woman.
Yeah, so this is it. So, yeah, he takes his elixir, his potion, or whatever you want to call it, and yeah, he transforms into a woman. So obviously I mean, I'm watching this when I'm younger and thinking, wow,
yeah.
We need to find where how to make this potion.
Susan becomes jealous when she discovers this mysterious woman, but when she confronts Jekyll to explain the sudden appearance of his female alter ego, he calls her Mrs. Edwina Hyde, saying she is his widowed sister who has come to live with him. Howard, on the other hand, develops a lust for Mrs. Hyde.
Yeah, so what happens is basically he transitions into a woman by taking this potion, and then the girl that he's attracted to upstairs, you know, the people start seeing Sister Hyde and his female side, and then he has to kind of like say, oh well, that's my sister, da 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 da, and kind of lie to them and stuff. And then it becomes where, you know, obviously he's aware, he's not like, he can't control her, so it's not like he is her. When he becomes her, she takes over his body. So it's not like he takes a potion and then he's female and he can go out and be female. It's not like that. It's like he takes it and then she takes over him. So it is like a bit like Jekyll and Hyde. There's no it's where one person, it's like two people in the same body. But just like Jekyll and Hyde, Sister Hyde is the baddie when it comes to this. She's not a good person.
Jekyll soon finds that his serum requires a regular supply of female hormones to maintain its effect, necessitating the killing of young girls. Burke and Hare supply his needs, but their criminal activities are uncovered. Burke is lynched by a mob and Hare blinded by lime.
I don't think that happens in real life. I believe they were actually lynched, hung in real life, but I don't... Obviously, it's just a story. This is just a fictional story. But, yeah, I don't remember why... If he is can't remember being a woman, I think that he does believe there's some benefit to this this elixir, this potion that he makes. So that's why he keeps wanting to get the female ovaries for his potion, or maybe he just enjoys being her.
The doctor decides to take matters into his own hands and commits the murders attributed to Jack the Ripper. Jekyll abhors this, but Mrs. Hyde relishes the killings as she begins to take control, even seducing and then killing Professor Robertson when he attempts to question her about the murders. As Mrs. Hyde grows more powerful.
Yeah, so, she starts to kill people. She starts to kill the men the men around her and vice versa. She kills lots of people and stuff. But she starts taking over him. She becomes more powerful throughout the film. He has no recollection of her. He doesn't know what she's doing. She takes over his body. So he doesn't know she's murdering. But I think he starts to realize.
The two personalities begin to struggle for dominance. Jekyll asks Susan to the opera. However, when he is getting dressed to go out, he unconsciously takes Mrs. Hyde's gown from the wardrobe instead of his own clothes, realizing that he no longer needs to drink the serum in order to transform. Susan is heartbroken when Jekyll fails.
So, yeah, to a point where he doesn't even need to take the serum. He just becomes her. So, it's getting worse for him.
To take her out to the opera, and she decides to go alone. However, the evil Mrs. Hyde decides that innocent, pure Susan's blood is just what she needs to finally take over Jekyll's body. She stalks Susan through the dark streets, but Jekyll's will only just manages to thwart Mrs. Hyde's attempt to kill Susan.
Mm. So, yeah, so basically, you can see, can't you? I mean, he's actually going to try and kill the woman that he actually loves, which is... So, obviously, not the same person. He loves her. It's not like he wouldn't kill the person he loves. So, she's totally taken over his body.
He then commits one last murder to find a way to stabilize his condition, but he is interrupted by the police, after a comment by Hare leads them to realize the similarity between Jekyll's earlier experiments on cadavers and the Ripper murders. As Jekyll tries to escape by climbing along the outside of a building, he transforms into Mrs. Hyde, who, lacking his strength, falls to the ground, dying as a twisted amalgam.
Well, I like that. So, when he transitions into her, he doesn't have the strength. So I mean, just I guess. But wouldn't the body also? I mean, sorry, just to kind of read into this. But wouldn't, if he was the guy and he's holding on, and he's stronger, fair enough. He's holding his body up, and then he transitions into to the female. But wouldn't he be lighter? Or they're just saying that women can't hold their own body weight, but men can. I don't know. But anyway,
So of both male and female. Thanks for watching. Please remember to leave a like on this video and hit that subscribe button.
So yeah, this is just a little video about that. I just thought I'd just cover that. I thought it was interesting. So yeah, I remember watching this when I was younger. I think I watched it a couple of years ago as well, and it was on TV. I was just one night I was watching TV and it was just on, so I watched it. I would recommend watching this film, not as like, I wouldn't say for someone like wanting to transition or something, but just for fun. And a lot of that type of film, like Hammer horror films and stuff like that, I think are quite enjoyable. So if you haven't seen anything like that, you should watch them because they are quite fun.